Hi guys, it's really hot today, so I'm going to keep this very brief and I'm just going to go through the books that I got. I'm not going to tell you anything about them, which is kind of weird considering it's a haul. I'm just going to show you the books, and if you are interested in finding out any more, Goodreads is only a click away. Also, I can always just tell you what it's about if you would like some more specific details. So I have 26 books. I hope to get through them in this video, so let's get started. I picked up Science 101 by Edward Ricciuti, and this is forensic science, because I'm interested in forensic science. And I may mention that these 26 books cost me $5 for the whole thing, so yeah. So let's start. Then I picked up a book called Accidentally Fabulous, which I believe is the third book in the series, and I think it is a teenage story. And the first two books are A Girl Like Moi and Project Paris, so I'm pretty sure if I like this one or like any of the books, I'll be picking them up, because Paris is one of my favourite cities. Sprite Downbury by Net Hilton. Oh, that was by Imogen Barham. And it says, Sprite's problems begin at home, but she has to leave to solve them. And I thought this was such a cute book. Most of these seem to be YA books, so, and they're in really good condition as well. Considering it's a library book, it's still in very good condition. 10 Mile Road by Paul Griffin. And I think this is about two brothers, and it's kind of a story about brotherhood, and I thought that was awesome. The cover was awesome, the premise sound great. It looks like a really short book as well. I tried to pick books that are in pretty good condition as well. Dirty Liar by Brian James, and this one is about a guy who tries to escape from his house, and he can't deal with anything anymore, and he goes to live with his father and stepmother, and his stepmother is nice but doesn't trust her, but he doesn't trust her, and his father is really hard to trust. And it's sort of kind of weird, because the novel I've been working on since 2008 has a character named Benji, and yeah, certain situations are quite similar, so I thought this would be interesting to read, and I love the name, so, and it's such a short book. And this one is by Brian James, and the back cover is that one. This one is a huge one, but it looked like it was in really great condition. I'm definitely getting into the thicker books, so this one is called Bella Poldark by Winston Graham, A Hero, A Heritage, A History. It's set in Cornwall from the 1880s. To the 1820s, so, and it's huge. I mean, like, 700 pages huge. Elizabeth Ashton's The True Darcy Spirit, A Girl Cannot Live on Talent Alone. Of course, I have been reading some Pride and Prejudice retelling, so I had to pick this one up. Exchanging Lives, Ever Wondered How the Other Half Live by Kathy Birchenen. I think this is a teen book. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. And it's very short. It's something I would certainly read. It's probably for a younger audience, but I really do like mixing up these kinds of books, and it's in great condition as well. Eva Ibbotson's Magic Flutes. And this is This is set in spring in the 1920s. And it looks to be a really fantastic book. It's a beautiful book as well. Very good condition. Yep, and a historical book, so I'm getting into my historic books. Nick and Nora's Infinite Playlist by Rachel Cohen and David Levithan. And I haven't read this book or seen the movie, but I thought, because I have been wanting to read this book for a while and I didn't really want to pay too much for it, I picked it up at the library. Bloodflower by Christine Hinwood. Melina Marchionessos says, I can't tell you how much I love this book. And I don't really read much of Melina Marchionessos, if anything, but this really did sound quite great. It says, vivid, compassionate, and totally absorbing, Bloodfire follows the fortunes of the young Kem Atling and all those whose fates intertwine with his. And the cover looks beautiful. It has a map in it. You got me sold with the cover. I love these covers. I'm very into Indian things, very into different ethnicities and culture. And I love this cover. Love it. Love the armor. Love the rich, vibrant colors. Then I picked up Breathing Underwater by Julia Green, a short story. And this is by Bloomsbury. I dream about him night after night. He is everywhere on the island because this is a place where he was happy and felt like he belonged. And it seems like it's a very, very short book, very cute young reader book, and I like the cover, it's cute. The Almond Picker by Simonetta Agnello Hornby. And as far as I know, this is about food, mortality, politics, and religion. And it's a literature book. It's more, it's not so much contemporary or something like that. I think it's more of a literature-based book. But it sounded interesting. Yeah, and it's floppy, so I've got a lot of those floppy books. Philip Reeves' Here Lies Arthur. And from what I gathered, it is about Arthur and that kind of time period, like medieval King Arthur type thing. And I love me some King Arthur, so I had to pick up that one. Perfect Weapon, another floppy old book that's kind of falling to pieces a bit, but I don't care. It looked interesting, sounded interesting. Kind of, it says danger in plain sight, and together they were the perfect weapon. So, you can't go wrong. Then I picked up a Deb Caletti book, The Fortunes of Indigo Sky. And I've heard a little bit of Deb Caletti about her and her contemporary books. There are some in the back here. It's about a 18-year-old, so I can kind of relate to that a little bit more than, you know, 15, 16, so definitely picked that up. And Pieces of My Heart by Sina Moriety, I can't pronounce her name. And this is a really actually quite beautiful book. It's got beautiful cover. Love the colours, love it, and it's falling to pieces a tiny bit, but with a bit of glue it should be fine. And it's a chick lit book. Obviously I'm not going to get to it too soon because I'm really not in the mood for chick lit, but I picked it up anyway because you never know when you are in the mood for one. And lastly, I have this pile of kind of mass paperback books. I went to Vaser for this, a novel by Naomi Neil, and this is set in the 1950s, so awesome time period. I love that kind of stuff. Laura K. Hamilton's A Lunatic Cafe, but it's a Anita Blake novel. It's a Anita Blake novel, and I'm collecting these slowly. Laurie Wilde, Addicted to Love, a romance. Succubus in the City by Nina Harper, and I believe I actually looked at this somewhere. I can't remember where I looked at it, but I'm pretty sure I added it to my wish list, and yeah, I'm quite happy to have it. I'm not sure if it's part of the first part of a series, but I'm certain I know about this book, so it's cute too. 204 Rosewood Lane by Debbie McCuma, because you can never have too many books by Debbie McCuma, even though I haven't read one yet. This one is called A Kiss at Midnight by Eloisa James. So it's a historical kind of book, historical romance, and it's in pretty shitty condition, like rough condition, but if anyone who knows me, I love my historical books used and read. Murder, She Wrote, Dying to Retire, and this is based off the series, I believe. So, I have watched a couple of episodes, so I love my crime. Another crime book, Devil's Right Hand, A Questionable Agenda, An Unrelenting Vendetta, and A Bloodthirsty Chase, by J.D. Rode. That's a really, like, whoa, look at that orange, it's like bright. It's not orange, it's green. And lastly, I kept this under 10 minutes, Dark Angel by Virginia Andrews. You know, it's Halloween, it looked like a really good book. I'm probably not going to read it for Halloween, but I'm in that mood, definitely in that mood, and I cannot wait to get home tonight to relax with a book. So, that's my book haul. I'm going to do my final test today, so after that I should be somewhat relaxed, but yeah, right now I'm stressing a bit, so I have to go and buy some books, and hopefully today I will probably be picking up two other books from the supermarket, markets, whatever you want to call it, Kmart, department stores. So yeah, that's a little haul to keep you guys going until I do my next book review or whatever bookish video I make, and I shall see you guys later. Bye.